And welcome back. Duke of the Bump here. When we last left off, I was on the bonus stage, which, as I was about to describe, has only white wabbits that release stars and time icons. The one catch to the bonus stage, though, is that you have to get to the exit before time runs out, or you don't get any of the stuff that you pick up. And if you collect all the wabbits in the bonus stage, you get some big point bonus or something. So, 14 seconds left on the clock, 13 wabbits left. It's about one wabbit a second. I think I can pull this off. Wow, that's kind of loud in my headphones. 3, 2, 1. Oh no! All wabbits saved. 50,000 points. That's pretty good. Let me turn my volume down here real quick. Hope that wasn't bleeding into my headphones. These things are kind of, or this microphone is kind of sensitive. So that should give us a nice little boost to our time. Now let's take a look at what vegetables slash fruit we collected. Strawberry and a carrot? That doesn't sound like a very appetizing combination. Let's buy something tasty to go with that strawberry. How about an orange? I know it looks more like a pumpkin, but trust me, that is an orange. And this thing is an onion, believe it or not. That's a lemon. That's a mango. This is a head of cabbage. And you're already familiar with apple, strawberry, and banana. And these are mystery items, which we will see in due time. Well, I should probably do something with that carrot too. Let's see what we get by spinning the wheel of randomness. Avocado? That's this thing. That costs 120 stars, but I got it for 60. That's a pretty good deal. Alright, let's see what carrot avocado does first. That doesn't sound very appetizing either, but who knows? Could be a tasty mix. Five extra stars? That's bogus, man. Yeah, there are some spell effects in this game that aren't really that overwhelming. But this one's pretty nice, if I remember correctly. This, my friends, is a bonus minigame. Let's see which one this is. Why, it's Splat the Dudes. And do my eyes deceive me? Why, it's Pugsy. Good old Pugsy. Let's, splatter him with tomatoes. I know these things look exactly like the apples in the actual game, but in the minigame they're tomatoes. Kind of ironic. Well, I guess it's not really ironic, as much as it is, I don't know. You might be wondering why I'm pelting poor Pugsy with produce. Well, the reason is, when you hit the ugly people with tomatoes, the only thing you get out of it is points, whereas if you cover Pugsy well enough with the delicious red fruit, then you get an extra life. Apparently, the game approves of this sort of behavior. I don't know. I think it's kind of mean. And I didn't mean to call them ugly. I mean, they're ugly in the game, but I'm sure in real life they're a couple of handsome fellows. I think that's the creators, Martin Chuzworth and Mike, whatever. Let's go to Lunar Land. Kind of off to a slow start here. Diddle! Well, that's not appropriate for a children's game. You know, this has to be probably the least violent game I've ever played. I mean, sure, there's a big freaking Morningstar mace in the background, but it's just a decoration. There really aren't any enemies in this game except the bosses. Uh-oh. I didn't get a mango. That's disappointing. Oh well, now I have a chance to get a banana. Yeah, the bosses in this game are, well, they're big. They're not quite as big as Colossi, but they are fairly intimidating. And your method of defeating the bosses is to, well, we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. and I'm sucking as far as time goes. Well, I got a pretty good amount of bonus time there. Alright, I got my banana, but nothing to mix with it. I don't think I can buy anything with 26. No, I can buy some time, but no point. You can sell stuff too, for half of what it's worth when you buy it. So, there are certain items that don't really do that much, like the cabbage. There aren't many good spells that involve the cabbage, so I usually sell that. I do plan on showing off every combination in the game, though, which is probably going to involve save stating, just to make things a little bit easier. Because the avocado and the mushroom, they can, they're pretty pricey. I hate it when you're collecting oranges, because when you start running out of time, the time icon looks almost exactly like the oranges, so it's kind of hard to see. One more, come on, where are you? Okay. 10 seconds? Bugger. That is a rather disappointing nurdle. Oh, there it is. Uh-oh. Oh, yeah. Alright, let's see if I can do this without dying. If you start abusing the extra time, eventually it stops giving it to you. Or it always seems like that's the way to me. This thing doesn't really look much like a cabbage either. Looks more like a veggie tail. Well, I guess they all kind of look like veggie tails. One more, one more, one more. Where are you? There you are. Alright. I think we can do something awesome with this orange. Let's see. We have 44 stars. And we can sell the cabbage for 20, which would give us 60. Oh, wait. No, I'm thinking of a different combination. Oh, wait. No, I'm not. I want to show you one of my favorite minigames in the game. It is orange lemon, which is a delicious combination on its own. But on Planet Plum, it gives you, well, something kind of broken, to be honest. But breaking games is what I do best. Takes us to Take a Chance. Basically, you have 3 10-ton weights, and, well, I think the premise is pretty self-explanatory. 10 extra stars, not really that great. Let's go for this one. 100 extra stars, wow! See, I've already made all my money back. 5 extra stars. Let's look into getting some time. 30 seconds, wow. Pretty good deal. You can probably, aw, I knew I should have gone for the time. You can probably see why I like that game. I only spent 60 stars, and I got a crapload of value for it. Uh-oh, my fairy's starting to blink. When your fairy starts blinking, that's that little white thing that starts hovering around you. That tells you in what direction a wabbit is about to explode. Yes, wabbits do start exploding in this game. On Sorcerer and Taxing, they start exploding a lot sooner. Where are you? There you are. And that's really, that's the really frantic aspect about this game, because, well, it's a lot to keep track of. Eventually, you start getting invisible letters, which actually make you lose letters, which, you know, wastes a lot more time as well. And if a wabbit explodes, you lose all of your letters. I guess that's a pretty violent aspect of this game, huh? I mean, sure, you're not killing anything, but you have to make sure cute little bunny wabbits don't explode. Uh-oh. 30 seconds on the timer, that's not bad. Alright, this banana's spinning really fast, which means it's probably about to die. Let's find something, some use to put it to. Actually, let's see what Banana Potato does. See, it's been so long since I played this game that I really only remember the really good combinations. 50,000 points. That sucks. Alright, so let's see. 131. Uh-oh. Time's up. My thing's not, it's not ringing, but I think I have it on silent, but it's flashing at me. So, that's been it for this edition of Let's Play Wiz and Liz. I'm Duke of the Bump. Hope you enjoyed. Be back with a new episode tomorrow. Till then, stay safe, everyone.